almost there. We'll pick it up tomorrow.
We're running late.
Your 5 o'clock is confirmed. You've got lunch tomorrow with Bob Geldof. Your bath is at 9. Story 10:30, sir. See you in the office.
Andy, you're in Lyrical Limo. How are you doing? You all right?
I'm well, mate. Thank you. And nice to be on the first one, I believe.
It is. Yeah, thank you so much for coming on. I know you're doing a gig tomorrow with us, but I thought I'd get you back in the car, have a bit of a sing-song, and chat about everything, modern romance and you.
Right, well, let's go for it.
Yeah. Should we go back in time a little bit and just sort of set the scene?
Okay,
can we do that?
Sorry.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, in the vehicle. Yeah. Okay. But yeah, I thought we could talk about how things all started out for you, because I know that you've kind of, you're vocalist now, but initially, I think, if I'm right, you started off on a different instrument.
I was originally the drummer. Yes.
Yeah.
I sort of came across the band in the Blitz Club, which is a very sort of, now very famous, it's a legendary club now because it's where the New Romantic movement began.
Yeah.
The Spandau Boys used to go there, and Steve Strange and
cool.
Culture Club were already in there. And I went in there one night, and this band had finished playing. Didn't get to hear them, but obviously they were packing up when I got there, and I thought, missed the band, never mind. So I started talking to the drummer, and said, oh, by the way, if you know anyone that's looking for a drummer, you know, I've just left my band. I'm in between jobs.
Yeah.
And I said, he said, give me your number. I'll see what I can do, you know. And a few days later, I got a phone call from that band saying, would you like to be our percussionist? And I thought, well, it's
brilliant.
A gig, you know.
Exactly, yeah.
I'm going to go and do percussion, yeah. And then before I could get around to doing the percussion, I got another call saying, were you the drummer in Blah Blah Band? It's this little cult band that I played in at the time.
Yeah.
And I said, yeah, that was me. And they said, oh, yeah, we heard the great things, you know, about them, and one of our guys in the band saw them. In actual fact, would you like to be our drummer?
No way.
And I said, well, what about your drummer, you know?
Yeah.
And they said, oh, to be honest, he had one foot out the door already. We were getting rid of it, but he doesn't know.
He doesn't know it yet.
And I kind of felt a bit guilty. And I said,
yeah, yeah.
And they said, well, look, if you don't take it, we'll give it to someone who will. You know, someone else will take it. So
yeah.
Why not you? And I thought, well, okay, you know, I got no choice, I have to take it, because as he said, somebody else will take it.
Absolutely.
So I joined them, started the rehearsal, and it was this band called Modern Romance, and we went to the first rehearsal. I knew nothing about them except for the fact that they were called Modern Romance, and
yeah.
I'd missed their gig, so I went to the first rehearsal to find out what's going on. And that's when the magic words, you know, as they were talking away in the corner, I heard record company blah blah contract, and I said, excuse me, sorry, did I hear right? You've got a record deal.
Yeah.
And they went, oh yeah, we've got a record deal. So
amazing.
Immediately elated, thinking, wow, I've joined a band who've got a record deal. How lucky is that? And then they added straight away. They said, oh, actually, we've got a record deal. In actual fact, we've already released two records. And I was like, wow. And they said, yeah, they were both massive flops. And the record company told us, if the third one's a flop, they're just going to throw us off the label. And so I was up there 1 minute, and then
straight back to reality.
Thinking, oh God, this is not that great. But I thought, I'm here now, you know, let's do it.
Yeah.
And then they played me their next single.
Yeah.
Which I have to explain, being a drummer who came from like a funk and soul background.
Yeah, yeah.
Pop really wasn't my thing at the time. Although now I'm a huge pop fan. But at the time, it was all about the rhythm, the groove, and as little vocal as possible.
Yeah.
It was all about jazz, funk, and stuff.
Yeah, get those instruments
and
going.
The slaps, and the bass.
Yeah.
So they played me this song, and I remember sitting there thinking, what the hell is this?
What have I done?
Everybody salsa. You know, it's a pop song. What am I doing, you know?
Yeah.
But looking back now, I think, mate, that song launched everything for you, the band.
Yeah.
But admittedly, at the time, I was quite blinkered when it came to music, I liked that sort of music. I mean, I liked that, I was a massive David Bowie fan, but aside from that, pop music for me, no, I want stuff with grooves and funk and all that stuff in it. But I soon changed my mind once I joined Modern Romance and started listening to what was in the charts as well.
Yeah.
You know, becoming not so much influenced, but realising that there's just so much out there, pop music wise.
Yeah, yeah, there's loads. Yeah. And I think when you kind of play stuff like that, you find different sides of the song as well, I guess. You know, if you might listen to it on the radio, you'd be like, yeah, that's all right, but not really my thing. But as soon as you start learning, actually performing it and putting your own spin on it, you kind of love it, really, don't you? You
and as you said, when I started putting my own little groove to it,
yeah,
and listening to what the rest of the band were doing, and thinking, because one of the reasons I became interested in them at the Blitz, even though I hadn't heard them, was I asked someone sitting nearby, I said, excuse me, I mean, this is, for me, this conversation, albeit brief, was very important in my life and my career.
Yeah.
Because I said to this bloke that I didn't know, I said, sorry, mate, I said, what were the band like? Because I missed them, what were they like? And he said, oh, they were pretty good, actually. He goes, in actual fact, they were quite funky. So hearing the words funky got me interested. And that's when I went over to talk to the drummer.
Brilliant.
And that whole thing, I often think, you know, the sliding door thing.
Yeah.
Had I not walked over to that bloke and asked him what the band were like, had I not gone out that night or gone to a different club, we wouldn't be having this conversation there, because I wouldn't be in Modern Romance. And
yeah, that's mad, isn't it?
Yeah.
But a lot of things happen like that as well, and I love the fact that, I mean, you spoke to him, but the description probably wasn't that accurate either, really, like funky, like you said, it was more poppy in a way.
It was poppy, but I think when I went to see them the first time, what I liked was there was this raw sound about them.
Yeah.
And there was quite a funky element to it.
Yeah.
The guitar playing was really quite funky. And that's what kind of drew me in, that whole sound. And I thought, do you know what? They're not bad. I mean, I went to see them before I went to the rehearsal, I should add, because I thought, I can't just come and rehearse with you, because I might walk in and you're all rubbish.
Yeah.
And then I've got the embarrassing thing of, like, trying to slide out surreptitiously with a drum kit.
That's it. Yeah, it's not exactly... You can't just walk out slowly or
just put
discreetly.
The bass drum in the top.
That's it,
That was
waiting for the storm out for 20 minutes, so just give me a minute to get out.
So I went to see them, and I remember being struck by, as I said, the sort of rawness of it. And it was a proper, earthy sound, and not overproduced, because it's live on stage, and I like that whole thing, and that's what got me interested. Once I started playing with them and realising, oh, actually, yeah, we can do this, and little patterns and stuff, it sort of took on a life of its own after
that.
And it was great.
Yeah, it's nice when it becomes you, doesn't it? And you kind of come in at a really good point, I guess. You know, like new music, they had a bit of a flop, like you say, but actually then when this new music came about, you were in from that point and could kind of influence that and be a part of it, rather than coming in, you know, some people might come into a band and they've already got these big number one hits.
Yeah.
And that's a hard thing to do, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I guess you were in quite early.
I love the fact that I joined and they were nobodies.
Yeah.
But then,
absolutely.
On the other side of the coin, within 8 weeks of joining, I remember I was standing in the top of the pop studio with my mouth open, looking, going, oh my God, you know, we're here. I'm here.
That's insane.
Yeah.
Amazing. And that's quick. Really quick.
Well, it was quick for me because I just joined them, but bear in mind they'd been with a record label for a year and trying to have success. But what happened, the actual fact, which is, you know, quite relevant, that I joined a friend of mine, a DJ in London, said, oh, you should come and do a PA here. PAs were very, very new at the time.
Doing
personal appearances, lip syncing sort of thing. And I said, what do you mean, PA? What's that? And
he said,
come along and sing. You just sing a couple of songs, or sing a song, your single. And give out a few copies of the records. Okay. So I suggested it to the boys. They'd never done one. No one knew what they were. So we went along and did it. And it was great. Went down fantastically. It was like doing a gig, but only one song gig, basically.
Yeah. And you get that more connection with people that follow your music as well, I guess.
Yeah, so everyone in there sort of like suddenly got to know, oh, there's this new band, Modern Romance. We saw them, right? But of course, that's just one club. There are hundreds of clubs and hundreds of millions of people in England. So the record company at the time did not want to put money into a band that's already had two flops.
Right.
To go on tour.
Wouldn't do it.
They said, no, we can't risk that. You've already had two flops. There's no guarantee this is going to be a hit. So I was sitting there scratching my head. And then I came up with this idea, and I said, why don't we do a tour of PAs?
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Get in the car.
Yeah.
We drive. So what we did, we actually drove to Birmingham. We did a club, I remember one of them was called Faces. We did a club called Faces.
Yeah.
So we spent about an hour there, you know, saying hello, signing stuff, did the song, you know, more records given out.
Yeah.
Then back into the limo to the next club. So we did like two or three in one night. Stayed the night in Birmingham, and the next day went to Wolverhampton and did a few clubs there.
Yeah.
And so doing that all over the country was massively helpful, because a lot of the DJs who were DJing in these clubs also did the local radio station.
Yeah.
So they would then go to the local radio station and say, at the club last night, blah, blah, had this new band in, Modern Romance, new single, we love it, here it is,
love
and
it.
They were playing.
Yeah.
So gradually, all the little provincial stations everywhere, all the locals, started playing us, and in the end, and this is over a period of 8 weeks, obviously, in the end, the BBC started playing it on, and all of a sudden, because you have to be in the top 40, you have to chart. We
course,
got, to number,
yeah,
got to number 38, and we were invited to do Top of the Pops, and that was it. It was like Exocet Rocket after that.
That's
took
amazing.
Off.
Yeah, I love it. It's so, it's just such a great way of doing it as well, because most people might have given up at that point as well. You know, it's been a flop, no label's going to be interested. Give up, but the fact that you sort of came off with a different way of doing it is pretty cool, isn't it? And had huge hits, which I think we should sing something as well. Do you fancy ever sing something?
Well, if you want me to, if you want me to ruin the good memory, yes, I'll sing.
Should we do it? Well, we can see what's on the radio, see what's on the track, see if we can have a sing song.
Okay, let's
take
some
swag. Should we do that?
Yeah, absolutely.
This is your thing. I'm just going to pop in with a bit of the BVs.
Okay.
All right. This is your moment.
Do you need me to cue you for the BVs?
I need many cues. All right. Cue away. Just a bit of a hand action will do me.
Okay.
All right. Shall we have a little see what's on?
All right.
See what's on. See what's on. Oh.
Right. It sounds
coming.
We are the audience.
We're everything today.
We're the audience. The act.
Yeah.
We've got to do some side to side.
Oh, okay,
side to side.
Yeah, if you can keep the cues going.
Yes. Oh, I can keep my keys and cues going. Oh, we're doing shimmy now, aren't we?
What, is that right? It just feels
okay.
Shimmy.
We can do that. Here we go. I ask you the questions, but you tell me lies. Cause all of the time you're just full of surprise. Please tell me if all this is true. Cause deep down inside all I wanted was you.
Oh, makes me wanna dance. Oh, it's a new romance. Oh, I look into your eyes. Oh, best years of our lives.
That's not bad, actually.
Such a tune, isn't it?
You've done this before?
Just a little bit, yeah. I've listened to this song a couple times, too.
When we first met, I could hardly believe the things that would happen and we could achieve. So let's be together for all the time. And thank my good fortune that you are still mine.
Oh, makes me wanna dance. Oh, it's a new romance. Oh, I look into your eyes. Oh, best years of our lives.
Woo. Now here there would normally be a little solo.
Oh yeah.
Like just a trumpet player.
Air solo.
Yeah, a little solo. Yeah.
The trumpet.
I ask you the question, but you tell me lies. Cause all of the time you're just full of surprise. And I can't understand why you tease me this way. My head's in a whirl and I just gotta say.
Oh, makes me wanna dance. Oh, it's a new romance. Oh, I look into your eyes. Oh, best years of our lives.
Okay, this is the breakdown. This is an audience. We,
okay.
So at this point, you get the
people
audience.
People at home.
Yeah. Are you ready?
Imagine.
Here we go. Oh, well, let me hear you. Makes me wanna dance. Can't hear you. Oh, it's a new romance. Come on, all the crew. Oh,
get the crew involved.
I look into your eyes. Oh, best years of our lives. Just some more. Keep going.
Keep going.
Crew,
come on,
crew, come on, let's hit the crew. Whoa! Yes! It's
in your
romance. Whoa! I look into your eyes.
It's still
shimmying. Whoa! Makes sense
of our lives.
Whoa! Right, so, after all the audience have done all this,
yeah.
Then we come in with a band. It goes here.
What do you get?
Keep going.
Whoa! Makes me wanna dance. Oh! It's a new romance. Oh, I look into your eyes. Oh, best years of our lives.
Oh, no, no.
Ooh.
Best years of our lives. I forgot about about this, yeah.
Oh, it's good, isn't it?
It's a new mix.
Oh, dancing on the left. Oh, I look into your eyes. Oh, best years of our lives.
Best years of our lives.
Yeah.
Best years of our... Ba-ba-ba-ba.
Yay! Yay! Andy for Modern Romance, everyone.
Thank you.
That was very fun, wasn't it? The audience was a bit quiet, but apart from that...
Yeah, I think we should get another audience.
Yeah, exactly. We'll get a better one next time, yeah. But I mean, a huge track, that.
No, it was. Hey? Very
unbelievable.
Good.
And everybody, what I love about that is that you mentioned Modern Romance, you mentioned Best Years of Our Lives, and people just transported back instantly to wherever they were. You know, I was here, or I was doing this, or like the senses are amazing. Well, I remember, you know, I was here and it was this really loud club, or you know, I can remember the smell of that club, or whatever it is. It's amazing, the senses that
what
people remember.
What clubs do you coach? The smell of that club.
You know what I mean?
What's going on there?
But you know what I mean about that? It's mad how the senses are connected to music. Oh, and you can literally absolutely remember every single sense where you were when you heard a certain song.
Do you know the senses? Obviously, hearing stuff always takes you back. The other thing is smells.
Yeah.
And the funny thing is, there's something that reminds me of a Modern Romance rehearsal. Every time I eat this thing, I smell it and I taste it.
No way.
And it is... I remember I went to a studio and for some reason, I'd never eaten this thing until I went to the studio and they were doing sandwiches and stuff. And I thought, oh, I'll try a bit of that, you know.
Yeah.
And it was... like, wow, this is great. Why have I not eaten this before?
Yeah.
And every time I eat it now, I think of the Modern Romance rehearsal, and that is sweet pickle.
No way.
Every single time, as soon as I smell it.
And that's got a smell, hasn't it? Yeah.
And I think, oh yeah, the rehearsal, when I first discovered it. Yeah, it just brings it back.
Isn't that funny? Yeah. I love that. And talking about the big hits. Well, obviously, there's so much going on now still. You know, we're gigging tomorrow down here in Devon, which is great to have you. And we thought, why not do a bit of this whilst you're here? But there's so much other stuff going on for you as well. You know, you're always on the AD circuits. I've come and seen a couple of those shows, which are just great fun. And there's some amazing artists on stage with you. But, you know, what else is going on for you at the moment as well? And let's talk about new stuff.
Well, I have all but finished my book. I've got to proofread it one more time and change a couple of bits in it. That I've got my kids to proofread it, actually.
Yeah.
And they said, oh, Dad, you need to do the tenses. You're jumping from...
Oh, okay.
You've got to make it clear when you're talking now and when you were talking then.
Yeah.
And I said, right, okay, I've got to go through it. Because obviously, as you're writing it, you write an entry based on your diaries from the 80s.
Yeah,
and
okay.
And then you comment on it. But I need to make sure that the comment is clear. That it's a comment that I'm making now.
Yeah.
Not then. Because otherwise it throws things out a little bit.
Yeah, right.
So I said, okay, I'll go through that and I'll double check those. But yeah, so that book is finished. So that's going to be an autobiography, which began as transcription of my diaries that I kept in the 80s.
Okay, yeah. That's cool.
And they're very, I have to say, I mean, as I was doing it, I was going, oh, should I put that in? And I thought,
do you know what?
If you don't put it all in there, it's going to be just a book about a bloke. You need to put all the
books. Yeah, true.
All,
what makes you you. Yeah, exactly. Your real journey. Yeah.
So even the dodgy bits, you know. I mean, let's face it. Let's be grown-ups about this. I don't drink. I don't smoke. I've never done drugs.
Yeah.
So there's only one thing left.
Yeah.
There you go. And there's lots of it in there.
But
being honest as well, I've left loads of it out because as I was transcribing, I actually got a bit bored and going, you know, this is getting like...
Here we go again.
Yeah, so now I've got to leave some of it out. It's just ridiculous.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that could be a separate sort of spin-off book.
Well, I don't know. I think it's just going to get boring. I got bored writing about it. I'm sure people get bored reading about how he got up and did the same thing as he did yesterday and the day before and the day before, which is, you know...
So sort of picking those highlights of those moments, I guess, really.
Picking the ones that are different, the ones that are memorable, for funny reasons,
exactly.
Or for whatever reason. So I've got some great stories in there about that, some great people that I met, obviously, through the 80s.
Yeah, amazing people,
bumped into, and people I would bump into regularly, like one of my favourites, George Michael. Loved him.
Yeah,
But loads of others as well, who, funnily enough, I see today on the 80s circuit.
Yeah.
It's really weird because I'll see them around and, you know, I remember getting on a plane once to go to Italy for this music festival and the boys from Spandau were on there as well.
Yeah.
I mean, now I see Tony everywhere. We're with different kids.
Yeah,
it's really weird that all these years later, 40 years later, we're still doing it.
Love it.
I feel very... very fortunate and very privileged to still be doing it, because who can say that they've been doing a job that long? And it's and well, I say job, I use the term loosely. It's
yeah,
not
I know
really
what you mean.
A job.
Yeah.
I enjoy doing it so much that I'd probably be doing it, you know, even if I wasn't in modern romance, but I'd still be playing music.
100%.
So,
yeah,
so to get paid for doing it and to experience what we have experienced.
Exactly.
It's amazing.
Yeah, and I love that. You mentioned you see him on the circuit still, but when I've come along to, you know, some of your shows and stuff like that, and backstage, it's like a family reunion in a way.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, mate, how are you? Got a great set, you know, what you've been up to recently, and that's nice.
It's
really
like,
nice.
If I remember, one of the ones you came wasn't Owen Paul in the next room.
Yeah, I think Owen, yeah, I've been to one with Owen's around, yeah, I mean, Owen Paul, yeah, he'll be down tomorrow as well.
Yeah.
Great guy. Absolutely brilliant guy. But,
funny bloke. Makes me laugh.
Yeah, he does. Yeah, definitely. But no, it's nice, isn't it? And you just catch up. But talking about catch up, that was a great catch up. Thank you for joining me in the Lyrical Limo. How much fun was that? I mean,
well,
it's not your normal interview, is it?
No, and also, I'm the first limo lyricist.
Yeah. Oh, hello.
How's that?
Hello. There's a quote for the website. We've got me started now. Absolutely. Oh, amazing. Oh, I appreciate that. Thank you. Let's do it again sometime.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Anytime.
And I'm looking forward to the gig tomorrow.
Pleasure,
it'll be a lot of fun. Yeah.
Definitely.
Take care.
So, anyone who's watching this, by the way,
yes,
if you're not coming to the gig tomorrow, why not?
Exactly.
I expect to see you all there.
Thank you very much. We'll send Andy round if you're not coming, will you?
Yeah.
That's a threat.
Send the Cypriot Mafia.
Yeah, exactly. Awesome. Take care and stay tuned, everyone. There's more to come. Thanks to Andy.
See ya. Bye.